I would like to introduce Mr. Sam Lovell. Sam and I go back many, many years, along with Mary Bowling. We I think we did the first coastal paddling map in Lake St. Clair. And Sam was our landscape architect and did a lot of great things for us. But he has over 35 years as a professional landscape architect. And he's done many projects all over the region, including the riverfront. He's done many urban planning projects, environmental planning projects. He also performed as a planning and landscape architect instructor for higher institutions, including Michigan State and Department of Horticulture and the School of Planning, Design, and Construction. Mr. Lovell's diverse experience also ranges from serving on the first board of directors for the Michigan Trails and Greenways Alliance, which is a big deal. So to initiating business ventures for environmental and urban planning projects in the People's Republic of China, so all the way across the world and back to Detroit. So we're grateful to have Sam working on this project. Let's hear it for him.
Thank you, Jerry. And welcome to the Lake Okonoka Project. It's very exciting. It's not new. It's not a new project. I think when I started this work on Lake Okonoka, I did pretty dark brown hair. I know it's starting to turn a little bit now, but seriously, it was like 2014, I think, when we were just conceptualizing the project. Construction started in 2017, so it's been a couple of years under construction, which is a long time to be building habitat restoration. A lot of people in this room I see have been working on it as well. Andy Hartz with the Eagle helped permit the project. Mary Bowling has been a stakeholder, very deeply involved. It's truly a community-owned project. We just need to figure out how to run this. We have a few partners along the bottom, funded by Great Lakes Restoration Initiative, obviously. Through NOAA. NOAA has been a great partner all along, and really is the true owner, if there is one, is the Public Advisory Council. This is the group that's working to delist the Detroit River as an area of concern, okay, AOC, when we start throwing around these acronyms. So that's a big effort. In that regard, the area, or the Public Advisory Council has a list of 14 other projects in the Detroit River that are all are at least started. The blue and the pink represent either underway or completed. The yellow is projects yet to be started, which are none. So we're really making some great progress in this regard to complete our projects that will essentially remove the fish and wildlife related beneficial use impairments. I know that's a lot of technical jargon, but it's very important in this whole delisting process. And of course, Belle Isle is a special place in that there's at least four projects on the island itself that are either completed or underway, along with some of these reef projects just to the east of the island where small fish are hatched and can now float right into the Blue Heron Lagoon, because that was one of the first projects completed in 2013, where we opened the island to the river, allowing small fish to come in to grow on in the new nursery habitat, and of course some spawning there as well. At the same time, we also constructed some work at the South Fishing Pier for nursery and spawning, which is all related then now to Lake Okonoka, where we're just opening the lake to the lagoon here and then outletting it on the south end of the island and building some new habitat along the shoreline as part of that project. So these projects all work together in conjunction with the wet music, 200 acres of wet music flatwoods forest, very unique association of plant material, very diverse, which then attracts a very diverse population of wildlife as well, so very, very important to the area. To understand Lake Okonoka, you really have to understand what Belle L was two short lifetimes ago. When John talked about paradigm shifts, less than 200 years, my lifetime and one other person before me would have seen no lagoon that was all filled, a big dike around the island, and then the lagoon was created with that fill material. The South Shore was nothing but a coastal marsh, okay, coastal wetland. John, I don't know if you mentioned, but the Detroit River used to have coastal wetlands for its entire length, as much as a mile wide in some areas. 97% of those wetlands are gone. And now, we're just now starting to realize those importance of those wetlands and have an opportunity to create them in some of these public areas such as Belle Isle. So that's basically what we're doing here at the South Shore, is recreating what was here not very long ago. Okay, so here's Lake Okonoka, looking in close, Blue Heron Lagoon to the upper right, and that's where, when we get out there, you'll see a new bridge over a 50-foot wide passageway that allows the fish to come from the lagoon into the lake, and then there's some deep channeling going on, and then a culvert that will be built under the road. So that's yet to come. We're getting close. This project's not quite there yet, but by the end of this fall, early winter, it's planned that this culvert will be completed, which will complete the project, as well as removing a portion of Woodside Drive, which then allows free flow of water from the forest into the lake area, which will benefit the restoration of the Flatwoods Forest as well. In doing this, there used to be a stop log structure that isolated the lagoon from the lake and then this whole internal canal system. That stop log structure is rebuilt at the mouth of the Nashua Canal, so the internal canals and other lakes are still isolated from the Lake Okonoka and the lagoon. However, this spring, we've experienced the highest water levels on record that have been recorded, and over a 100-year flood. So we are seeing some overtopping of water into the National Canal, which has raised some of the levels of the lakes at Lake Tacoma and Muscadet as well. So it's a temporary situation. We're all certain in that. As the water level subsides, we should be back to a normal condition. So out of this project, we're looking at restored hydrology that will enhance that 200-acre wet music flatwoods, restored lake water quality. We got the Great Lakes water coming into Lake Okonoka now, which used to be very stagnant and basically completely clogged with Eurasian milfoil. That's all been removed. We had fresh water in there, 25 acres of additional Great Lakes fish spawning and nursery habitat, combined with the Blue Heron Lagoon, so it's close to 80 acres. And of course, with this high water level, it's probably close to 100 acres, because when you see the size of Lake Okonoka, it's very impressive, okay? And then, of course, 400 lineal feet of restored Great Lakes shoreline on the south edge of the island as well. So here's what happened this spring. Lake Okonoka was opened to the Blue Heron Lagoon, and at the same time, the water in the Great Lakes reached these record high levels, okay? And of course, the Great Lakes shorelines, this is not just unique to Belle Isle, but the Great Lakes shorelines, the entire area are experiencing flooding. Ironically, at the same week that all this happened, the UN releases a report on biodiversity, indicating that 1 million species will become extinct in the next two decades. 1 million species, that's plants and animals, but that's a lot of species that will no longer be here in a very short time period. And what they're claiming is that coastal wetlands are among the largest challenges to rethink. Okay, that's the big issue worldwide. So the bottom line, here's another paradigm shift, as John mentioned. Detroit is taking the lead. We're stepping up. We're doing something that's pretty dramatic on a very public space where everybody in the city has ownership of, and making some changes. And it's definitely a dramatic change when it's done at the same time as these high record water levels. So everybody needs to understand that. And as time goes on, we're anticipating that it will bring about some great benefits. We've already seen, as was mentioned, you know, eagles nesting, common fox snake, turtles are back. Just 2 weeks ago, we spotted a spotted gar was observed in the lake. Okay, so here's a shot of it. We didn't quite get his face, but a side view was pretty good. And these are kind of a rare fish. You know, it's pretty unusual to be seeing a spotted gar. So in the big picture, this is what we're looking at. The Blue Heron Lagoon's open. A new passageway under the strand into the lake, and then culvert out that'll happen this fall. Pretty exciting. Fish passing, that's a big one right there. And of course, recreational benefits with kayaking. New bridge. You'll notice it's not going to look exactly like that, but it does allow kayaks to pass underneath, so we'll be able to come through the canal system, under the bridge, out through the lagoon, and back over to Lake Muskoday. So huge recreational benefits as well as the environmental ones. Thank you.